Hey everyone, Halfway to Heroic here again, along with Monty, and we are going to play more Enter the Gungeon. Today we will be playing as the Convict. Now, I don't play with the Convict much, but we'll see how things go. As you know, I normally stick with the Huntress because I like that crossbow with the one-hit kill in the beginning. Anyways, people may think that that makes life a little too easy on you and you need to develop skill. I am so glad those things don't do any damage. Like, there are some of those little purple guys that do damage whenever they bombard you, I'll say. But the ones in the beginning, well, most of the ones in the beginning don't. So, you know, we're good. We're chill. Yeah, you guys like that. You guys like that epic dodge right there. Dodging a ghost. Never thought I'd see the day. No, I knew. I actually knew this day was coming. Ever since I was a young lad. Got him. Got him, got him, got him! Okay, cool. I'm so glad that wasn't one of the grenade guys. Got him! No, I got him! Betting that's a buck up there shooting at me. Let's try the budget revolver. Got him. Ha. Okay, we're doing good. We're doing good. Monty, how are we doing? That's right, Monty. I guess I am doing okay if I haven't got hit yet. Immediately get hit afterwards. That would suck. Monty would laugh at me. Ah! Ah! Oh jeez, it sort of feels like trigonometry is attacking me, or geometry. Squares and other shapes everywhere. And in that split second, I have to figure out the area and the radius and the diameter and the circumference and all those things just to be able to dodge it. But you know what? Somehow, we get by. So what are we hoping for right now? Better gun and more health is usually what we go for. What kind of better gun? Oh, jeez. I really like the... I don't even know if I have it in this game yet, but later on there'll be this gun called the Vertebraker, or something like that. I think it's Vertebraker. Anyway, and every bullet you shoot connects with the bullet that you shot previously, so you basically have like this giant chain of bullets connected and swaying all over the place while they're connected. And it's just a super awesome gun! And you combine that with like electric rounds and you're gonna do some damage. So we got the RPG leveled up. Get it? Because in RPGs or role-playing games and you level up in them, HA! An RPG also stands for Rocket Propelled Grenade, in case some of you didn't know. Well, I'm sure all of you did, though. You're all smart cookies out there. You're still alive. is gasping, dying. Oh god! Did you know there's people shooting at me out there? Yeah, you're in the Gungeon? Gungeon? I thought this was a Fungeon. And I laugh, and the shopkeep laughs, and the bullets laugh, and then I get shot. Oh, wrong gun. fire handgun, fire shotgun. Okay, it's not powerful enough. Fire rocket launcher. Too much, too much. Oh jeez. Oh no! I got hit. Monty, are we doing okay? Monty's not talking to me because I got hit. Alright, we have 45. We can go back and buy that marksman carbine from the shopkeep. How did I forget shopkeep for a moment? Stay away from me! Stay away from me! Oh, I don't know if it was on a playthrough or not, but I get killed by one of those guys through a wall. I'm like, no! This isn't right! It's not supposed to be this way! So let's go ahead and go back to the shopkeep. Buy that marksman carbine. Sounds good to me. Hey. Higemoni carbine? Yeah. And let's go fight the boss. This is going so much better than the last round I played. You stay on the other side of that wall, fool. I don't know if you've noticed, but I don't like this fellow. See, whenever he stands still and fires, it's not that bad. Yeah, I can dodge those ones. It's whenever he's running towards me that makes things difficult. And we've had this conversation before. But like him, I'm so much of a bird brain, I'll repeat myself 1,000 times. Get it? Bird brain? Because he's Gatling Gull, and he has a bird head. we didn't get hit on the boss, so we get our special extra health item thing. And we got another key, protective plush, that's really good. That gives us that extra, or that invulnerability area. What is this? Some floors are familiar. Good, good. We weren't going to use that Molotov much anyway. The Molotov, you didn't get to see it, but it sets the ground on fire. Imagine, right? A Molotov cocktail setting the earth aflame, ablaze. It'll be fine. Everything's fine. Okay, so here we are on level 2. So, what are we looking for now? Let's see, what would be good right now? I'm always interested in finding that beehive. Beehive is freaking awesome. Beehive is a boss killer. More damage output. That's for sure. If I get like heavy bullets or something like that. Jerk! Oh no, a bullet's coming at me. I have have a bright idea. Shoot the bullets. I know what you're thinking. Hero, you flipped that table at the perfect time. And yes, yes, I know. I know. I am also proud of me. I don't like these guys. I don't like these guys. Why? They're better than me. Oh god, I really don't like those guys though. I'll just stand here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Where's your, where's your buffing mage? Buffing mage! I'm going to pump you up. With the power of lifting weights. That's a buffing mage, if you hadn't guessed. Boom.
Oh! Oh! Oh no!
Bullet hell? More like bullets. Aw, hell. Am I right? Stop talking.
But I want to talk.
And so I shall continue to talk. About what in particular? Nothing. I shall talk about absolutely nothing. Have you thought about the concept of nothing? And we actually proceed to talk about nothing. I mean, a long time ago, me and my friends were hanging out. Me and my friends and my cousin. And at one point, one of my friends said that if something exists, it's not perfect. In order for something to be perfect, it can't exist. That way, nothing is perfect. And so, a little bit later, we were playing with a laser pointer, and the same friend that said nothing is perfect is shining a laser, and he says, "Oh wow, this laser, it's perfect." And my cousin goes, "So you're telling me that laser doesn't exist?" And my friend is just a, "Shut up." I know what I said. Don't you use my own logic against me. Ah, good times. Maybe we should talk about dreams. Would you all like to hear one of the dreams I've had recently? I've told some friends at work, but I haven't really talked about my dreams on the YouTubes. The last dream I had, I was in the sky, and I was running on like these giant licorice arm things, and they were curving all every which way. And I was just like running on them. They might not have even been licorice. They might have been like a Twizzlers brand type thing. Yeah, they look more like Twizzlers. You know that one game, Yarn or Gone Home or something like that, where you play as a little red yarn ball guy? Anyway, it was like those, but in the sky, and they were made out of candy. So I was running on them. And at one point, I fell off, and I was going, you know, falling down. Oh, jeez, man. Okay, screw you guys in particular. Anyway, so I was running and I fell off. And whenever I fell off into a tree. And in said tree, there was like this giant, Cheerio monster. It was like a giant Cheerio and it had like one eye sitting on top of the Cheerio and like teeth and like wasp wings. I'm like, oh no! The whole ordeal was truly frightening for me. You ever been chased by a giant wasp, Cheerio? I have. I did not enjoy it. Well, all in all, it was a pretty good dream. I don't remember what happened after that, though. I definitely didn't get eaten. Although I have died in my dream before, that was weird. I died and become ghost. No, I died and I became a ghost. Let's see, what was it? It was at a birthday party type thing, and it was a birthday party type thing for me. And all my friends were there, which is weird, because I don't have friends. Anyway, so, we were at the birthday party. And there was, like, this mass murderer that came, and he was, like, attacking everyone. And we're like, oh, no! So then we ran, and I ran down into, like, this sewer system. And while in the sewer system, I was, like, hopping on rocks. And at one point, I fell, slipped, and, like, went under the water, and I couldn't get back up, because I got knocked unconscious. And so I'm just sitting there laying, the water's rushing over me, and then I, like, get up without my body, and I'm like, oh, I'm a ghost. And so then I was, like, just walking around, and seeing all these other people running from, like, the mass murdering guy, the guy. Oh, jeez, what do we want to get with that? Let's go ahead and get that green chest. So all the other friends and stuff were being chased by the mass murdering fellow. And so I'm like, oh, well, I can't do anything because I'm a ghost. And then I fought, like, this giant angel thing in battle. I won. Then I, like, eventually got out of the sewers and I walked outside. And everything was on fire and there was a zombie apocalypse. Aw, man. Alright, whenever she does that scream, you can't move, you're paralyzed. Oh, dang it! Couldn't see what she was doing. Yeah, laugh while you can. Okay, I can see how long that lasts. Cool! So I went outside and everything was on fire and the zombie apocalypse was happening. And so I'm like, oh no! And then I saw this crazy unicorn and it ran up to me going, ah, la, 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 la. It was like, la, 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 at me, as said unicorns do, you know? And table tech flip multiplier. Okay. Anyway, so it was going, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, oh geez, so I ran from that, and I ran to a zombie Colonel Sanders, and the zombie Colonel Sanders was like, you're not chicken, and I woke up. How about that for a dream, right? That was quite the dream. Oh geez! Got overzealous, I'm just like, here I am! And, ow. Ouchie caboodles. Oh, no, stop what you're doing. I almost ran into that bullet as it was flying away from me. I'm like, get back here, I want to be hurt. Yeah, this hurt me so good. That's a way to do it right there. Stop it! Stop it, you goo! That stuff they're leaving behind is poison. In case you were wondering. Oh! Oh, snap! No! No, no! Not like this! See that little poison bar going off? going up whenever I'm standing on the poison stuff. See that poison bar? That means I'm being poisoned while I'm on the poison? Yeah, that's not It's not good. I don't approve. Ah! Oh man, I rolled right into the laser that time. Things like, you'll never guess where he's at. He's over this way. Just like, shut up! I know exactly where he's at. I probably should be killing that other green fellow first, since his bullets are... worse! His bullets are worse! He fell off into the... acid vats. Awesome. I approve. I don't approve of this situation where they all freaking duck down. Whoa! Right before he hit. I'm like, you ain't nothing on my watch, fool! And then I shot him. Go ahead and buy another key. We need all the keys we can get. Mulcher. Let's give him sawed off. Yep. Wonder if this has like a formula for calculating what we get. Yep, eat it. So sawn off and hegemony carbine give me a bow. Is this like out of spite for me saying, you know what my favorite character is? The Huntress, because you start out with the crossbow and they're just like, fine, here, have your freaking bow then. Oh wow. No, this is freaking awesome, never mind. Boom! No, is it like you let go at the perfect point to get maximum damage? Or is it just like, fire when it's fully charged, man? Monty, which is it? Monty thinks you have to press at a certain time. Like in, the beginning of Mario Kart, where you get that little extra boost if you hit it correctly. Yeah, you guys know what I'm talking about. Oh, it helps if I actually hit, right? No. Boom. Thank you. Jeez, I'm crow, meow. To have a bunch of chickens, actually. Yeah, I used to have like 30 chickens or something like that. And then one day, a dog got in the pen and ruined everything. Stop this nonsense! I'm just gonna stop the 4 mining carts barreling at me. Ooh, lag right there. Did I just fire 2 arrows? Oh, you know what? It's cause, I flipped that table. It gave me, like, bullet time. That's what that one, item I got was. See? Boom. Yep. Boom. 2 bullets. No, 3 bullets. Wow. Crap. Let's see. Where do we want to go? Chest over there. There's a chest over yonder. Oh, why are there... Why there be 2 bosses going on over here? Okay, where's this, where's this fellow at who's doing all this? Oh, there he is. Okay, good. 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 We need to pick up the pace a little bit. We're not going fast enough. What is this? Silencer 300 dead count. Oh, wait. It's another Gungeoneer. Hey, man. Hello, friend, and well met. What brings you down to the Gungeon? Looking for the gun, same as everyone else. Oh, that's a relief. I mean, of course you are. We abandoned that quest not long after our fool of an assistant ran afoul of some bullets. See you around, adventurer. Okay, it says there's a boss in here. Like, up on top in the... I'm not quite certain what you mean. You must be here to kill your past. Manny says hi. Ah, I see. You understand I won't just roll over, right? I do. Well then, look out behind you. It seems my past has caught up with me. Time to kill it. Oh, can he just do that move? That is good. Oh jeez, some guards. I didn't know that. I didn't see them. What the heck? Oh, that was a nightmare. I need a drink after that. This is coffee, by the way. I'm going to work later. Alright, return to the breach. So that was the convict. Back to the hunter. Let's go ahead and see what we can buy in this area up here real quick. Ba-doom! Gamma ray, sure, why not? And Thompson submachine gun. Yes, we bought everything for now. There is going to be like a ton of stuff later. Anyway, so we're going to go ahead and end this episode here. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm Halfway to Heroic. That's Monty. And if you enjoyed the video, like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, let everybody, let the whole family enjoy. So anyway, I hope all of you out there stay heroic.